As an example of agricultural innovation, this is one of the most recent to have hit our paddocks, the Harrington Seed Destructor. Now in limited commercial production, many grain growers will know of this invention and heard of Ray Harrington, the West Australian who conceived and developed this heavy-duty weed seed terminator.
And the project was the big C. I was going to catch it, crush it, cart it, cook it or cremate it.
An organisation that has long supported agricultural innovation is the Grains Research and Development Corporation. This experimental robotic seeder is being developed by the University of New South Wales with the corporation's help. Late last year, to further encourage this type of innovation, GRDC launched the Grain Inventors Competition.
Now we know there's lots of growers out there and lots of people out there that are tinkering in a back shed, that are looking at new ways of doing things and have got ideas that they're testing out. We want to see some of those innovations and we want to show them to the world.
Looking for a better way to do things is what got Paul Hicks' brain ticking over. Like a lot of WA grain growers, he has to deal with non-wetting soils and poor crop establishment. Even a new seeder didn't fix the problem.
Where we'd been able to place the seed in the previous year's row, we got a 90-95% crop germination, and where it was in the inter-row, we were getting terrible germination, and it was actually wasn't germinating until we'd had a follow-up rain.
Digging down across the row revealed the reason. After rain, it was clearly visible that the moisture had followed the stubble down into the soil. Between the rows, there was nothing.
That was the eureka moment, I guess. After that, it was just a matter of mechanically, how do we get this thing to steer in the right spot and not block up and put the seed where it needs to go in the wetter. So that, I guess, was the inspiration to develop the system.
A system that required the development of a steerable drawbar, a stubble sensor to guide the seeder's path, and a customised seeding boot.
The seeding boot's quite unique in that we actually seed to the left about an inch or 25 mil. So the knife point is actually going up the side of the previous year's row. And then we have a wing that hangs out to the right and places the seed into the moisture.
Touchscreen control, a camera to monitor how the seeder is tracking, drawbar hydraulics, and an electronics module that can be retrofitted to most tractors built in the last 10 years complete a systems package that Paul Hicks calls intelligent tillage, or ITIL.
The driver, he just lifts the seeder bar up and down, and that's all he has to do. The rest of it looks after itself. So the combination of all those things is what's unique. Each of the technologies has been around, but it's the combination that makes ITIL unique.
Paul Hicks and his project partners have so far invested more than $100,000 into the system, which has grown from concept to reality in just 12 months.
Yeah, the investment is a big part of it. And, you know, what the GRDC is doing at the moment with the Innovation Award and helping promote that within the industry is critical.
The competition entrant who comes up with the best invention to benefit the grains industry will receive GRDC support to the value of $15,000 for the design, testing and development of their invention.
Well, at the end of the day, we don't care where the innovation comes from, we just want to make sure we capture the benefits of that innovation.
The winning invention might be the best thing since the stump jump plough, and it could also be that one glint of inspiration needed to keep other unrecognised grains industry inventors tinkering and burning the midnight oil as they work on their own innovative ideas.